somebody else. Good morning. It's time for a daily parable. Thanks for being up so early and joining me. I get up early every morning. Spend time in prayer and worship. I love to walk and worship the Lord. A lot of times I just read through scripture and find worship songs that I really enjoy. Talk to the Lord and have the Lord talk to my heart. That's what reading the parables is all about. It's all about talking to the Lord and letting the Lord talk to us. We're in Luke. Luke chapter 15. It's the parable of the lost coin. The book of Luke has so many parables in it. In fact, Luke has more parables than any other gospel. And chapter 15, well, it's probably one of the best known chapters when it comes to parables in the whole Bible. There are three parables found here in Luke 15. The parable of the lost sheep, the parable of the lost coin, and the parable of the lost son called the prodigal son. Our story today is the story of the lost coin. In this parable, Jesus again is speaking to the Pharisees. And they're pretty hard-hearted. And they won't have anything to do with what they call sinners. Of course, they don't see themselves as sinners. They look at other people and judge them, but they're above all of that. Anyway, they look down on people very harshly. And Jesus responds to that attitude of arrogance by giving them these three parables. Now, this parable, the parable of the lost coin, it's a parable where he says to them that they have this lady that had 10 silver coins, and she lost one of her 10 coins. And when she lost her coin, she started looking for it, and she wouldn't give up until she found that coin. And then she began to rejoice. And Jesus says here in Luke chapter 15, verse 10, that all the angels in heaven rejoice when a lost sinner is found. Jesus is speaking to us and telling us three very, very important things. Number one, everyone is important to God. That's number one. Unlike the Pharisees that would categorize people and treat people differently, Jesus didn't. Jesus taught that everyone is important to God. Have you ever found a $20 bill in the parking lot? Maybe you have. Have you ever seen people look down and say, oh, that's only a nickel or a quarter, I'm not going to pick that up? Here's the deal. Everyone is important to God. Everyone. And God never gives up on people. No matter who they are and what they've done, God never, ever gives up on people. And finally, the third thing that we see in this parable is the celebration. That's right. In this story, in this parable, we see the celebration in heaven. The Bible says that all the angels of heaven begin to rejoice and they begin to celebrate because someone has given their heart to God. I'm so grateful that you're reading the parable, that you're taking time out. I especially want to encourage you that when you do a prayer walk or you spend time with the Lord, that you just lay a few things out for yourself. Number one, that you spend time in worship with the Lord. When I worship the Lord, I like to find songs and music that I really, really enjoy. And they're worship songs, not just any kind of song. But the second thing I do is I open up the Bible and I focus on the Word. And when I say focus on the Word, that's what a parable is. It's the Word of God. And the reason why that's important is because when you focus on the Word of God, you're not just talking to God, but God is talking to you. And today, what is the Lord saying to my heart? The Lord is saying to my heart, Bill, God cares for everyone. And Bill, other people may give up on other people, but God never gives up on anyone. And Bill, when someone gives their heart to me, all the angels in heaven begin to rejoice and they begin to celebrate. Well, thanks for reading the parables with me. Thank you so much. And remember, I hope you can hear the angels sing because somebody in your family or one of your friends has given their heart to the Lord. Oh, I am so grateful that you are joining me in our journey through the parables. Remember, God loves you. God loves you. And so do we. You be blessed today.